Hey there, YouTube. My name is Brandon with Be Aircooled, garage in Glenview, Illinois, devoted to air-cooled vintage Volkswagens and Porsches. We also do exotics and Italian cars. And today, we are working on a Lancia Delta Integrale Evo 2. Now, this is a 16-valve turbo car and all-wheel drive, very cool car. We're doing a shakedown on the fuel pressure system. The reason why we're doing that is because the car has a stumbling at idle, pretty nasty problem where it just hunts for idle and stumbles a lot. It's also running rich. We've measured it at the tailpipe. We'll probably get into a little more of that, tuning and dialing it in as we go about this process. But what I want to show you right now is how to start your basic fuel pressure regulator shakedown test and also a fuel injection shakedown test. See if your injectors are doing as they should or if they're leaking. So we're going to do a leak down test on the injectors and we're going to check the fuel pressure regulator. This is an Evo 2 car, and on the Evo 2 cars, your fuel pump relay is on the back side of the firewall right here, and it's a double relay unit. So this is the fuel pump relay unit here. On your Evo 1 cars, it's an ice cube relay. It will be back here as well. On the Evo 1 cars, you're jump ring between pins number 87 and pin number 30. So you're going to go between 87 and 30. I've got a jumper relay that I've set up here. I use this when I'm working on Porsche 911 Motronic cars to test their fuel pump relays, which is a common problem with those cars as well with no starts. So I've got round pins soldered up to an on-off toggle switch with a 7.5 amp fuse in line. I've gone ahead and adapted this by cutting open some ring connects. You can solder up or firm up your wire just by twisting it. I do recommend coating it with a little bit of solder. It'll help it push into the pin clips on the serial port connector a little easier. But we've gone ahead and done this setup, and it's going to make it nice and easy for us. So we're going to start by cutting loose the fuel pump relay back here, little 10 millimeter flange nut that is holding it, and then we can pull it off of its mount. Sorry about the lighting, guys, trying to make it not as direct. And then there's a bail clip at the front, and this is a pretty simple connector with a spring on both sides, and it's a bail spring. Even though it looks like you pop from both sides, we actually do push in kind of firmly here, and that will actually open up the bail spring on both sides. So you can use a screwdriver if you need to, but my thumb kind of jams in there decent. Wiggle the relay and it'll come out. The relay diagram is on top, and we're gonna be jumping between pins number 9 and pin number 11, so on the outside side here. 9 and 11, and as we look on the inside of the relay, there's also numbers on the pins, and try and get some light on 9-11 for you guys, if I can. There we go. So you can see 9 is the upper left, and 11 is the third one in from the upper left. Trying to get the camera focused. There we go, 9 and 11. So I'll point to them on our plug port here. We're looking at, being that they were upper left of the plug the way I was holding it, that means that they're actually lower left, as the relay is installed like this. So when I flipped it, we were looking at upper left. The upper line is actually the lower line, if you note how it's gonna plug. So we're going to this pin right here, which is number 9, and then you hop over one and you go to this pin here, third from the lower left, which is number 11. So we're just gonna install our jumper relay between those two pins. I've pushed one end in there, and now we've got the other end installed. And now we're in on that. Now the next part of our fuel pump, fuel regulator, now we've got the fuel pump jumper basically, but the next step to shaking down the fuel regulator in the fuel pressure system is to tee in to the fuel line at the bottom of the rail. The bottom of the rail here, sorry about the clicking, that's the light mount that keeps clicking in the video here. At the bottom of the rail here, I'll try and get my hand in to show it. Maybe I can't. But the lower portion of the rail, Justin's got a good close-up on it there. Justin's our cameraman today.
The lower portion of the rail there is held in with a hard line and a compression fitting. We've gone ahead and stepped over the threads on it with a rubber hose, large diameter rubber hose, and then stepped it down in a manner that we needed to adapt our fuel pressure regulator, because I did not have the right adapter for that compression fitting. I have everything for German cars, and occasionally I get lucky working on some of the Italian cars that we get in the shop, but sometimes we have to improvise like that. So you're going to tee in there, and then the next place that you're going to need to have some operational control is right here. So in your fuel pressure tester, you're going to need to have a ball cock valve or a shutoff valve. And that's more important for the leak down test that we're going to show you in the next video. But as long as you're going about installing the system, make sure that you have that as part of your fuel pressure fuel pressure gauge system or measuring system. So we're teed in between the fuel rail and the fuel filter now. And now we're going to test our fuel pressure regulator, and then I'll explain to you how the fuel pressure regulator works and the secondary test to go about after you complete this first one. So we're going to go ahead and give the fuel pump some juice by flipping our switch on, and we'll see where we get to. So it looks like we're getting to about 46 psi, which is about 3 bar. And I've shut it off immediately there. You don't want to run for more than about 10 seconds with that. 3 or 4 seconds is a nice little rundown, because you don't want to back up the fuel system too much or burn the pump out, run the risk of overheating anything. So the way that the fuel pressure regulator works, what did we just test there? We just tested to make sure that the fuel pressure regulator, which on this Evo 216 valve engine should be a 3 bar regulator, and we are hitting 3 bar. So what we tested was the internal valve of the regulator. The way this regulator works is it takes fuel off of the rail post injectors, so we teed in before the fuel injection rail. So post injectors, it runs a hose to the regulator. There's a valve in the regulator that prevents fuel until it hits a certain pressure from backfeeding through return line to the tank. So the return line to the tank in this case is on the fuel pressure regulator. This is step one test. Step two test would be to remove that fuel return line and make sure that the fuel return line isn't jammed up. That would be if you're seeing excessive pressure. We're not really seeing excessive pressure. It's still a good secondary measure to shake down your fuel pressure regulator. You have to take that bottom hose off. We'll show you where that's at. It's this hose here with the blue text on it. You're gonna have to take that bottom hose off of your fuel pressure regulator, and then you'd run a hose that's empty-ended to a gas can or a catch can. You'd run that outside of the car to the floor, put your gas can down on the floor, run a hose into it, do this exact same test again, and you should see the exact same measurement or figure. So let's say your fuel pressure regulator was, or the return line was blocked, you would get a high pressure reading on our test here, and then you'd have to take the next measure to make sure that the return line isn't kinked or jammed going underneath the car. That'll do it for this section of things, and we'll be back with you for an injector leak down test. Thanks for checking in.